Creating a fluted bowl. Okay, we're going to start out with 2 pounds of prepared clay. It's already been wedged. Let the wheel hit a little bit. Just want to damp, but I don't want it soaking wet. Now does the clay stick to the wheel? Center the clay. It's a little on the stiff side, it's been sitting around for a while. Alright, so open the center up. Drop down, just up about a half inch on the bottom. Light open a little bit so you can see what's going on in there. Compress the bottom. Press the bottom. Press the top. Sponge with the water. That's your first pull. Press the top ring. Slow the wheel down a little bit. Second pull. Some of that clay off that bottom. Pinching, pulling, pull up. Slow, even. A little water on it. Slow, even pressure. Get it up to the top. Don't make the top too thin. Leave yourself some meat on the top of this thing. Too thin, and then it can work with later. There's a lot on the bottom still. I'm gonna push in, get under that clay, turn your finger and pull it up. As you get near the top, lighter pressure, cut your speed down a little bit. You're going to take a parting tool and cut some of this goo off the bottom of this thing. We don't need all this down. Get rid of some of that. A little undercut. The wire. This is ready to be turned into a bowl, base, mug, whatever you choose to do with it. I think I'm going to lay it out, make a bowl out of it. Just like making bowls. I'm going to use a rib. Probably something similar to this rib. Okay. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to try to just straighten the outside up a little bit. Get a little cleaner edge. Take some of the slip off of it. Just makes a neater appearance when you're all done. Keeping it wet. Go inside and lay the bowl down some. Slowly open it up. Now, there's more than one way to do this. Sometimes I like doing it this way, sometimes I like just making the whole bowl all one piece with your hands. And it really doesn't matter. You just work it slowly. If you work it too fast, you bump it out of shape and you never know what could happen. You could end up losing it, it could slump on you, it could fall. So you want to just kind of real nice and slow. Work it out, and keep working the knot. Make sure you get that turn in the bottom of the bowl. That's the way bowls are. With a spoon or forks or whatever, don't catch in the bottom of the bowl. You get a nice, clean turn in the bottom of your bowl. And that's what the bottom of this rib's doing right here. Give me that nice clean turn in the bottom of the bowl. You don't get a hump in the bottom of your bowl. Okay, so if you want a deep bowl, you can kind of stop right there. If you want a shallow bowl, you need to just keep laying it out. Add a little water to it. Go for just a bit more shallow. And I think right about there is about where I'm going to stop. I like that shape. It's pretty good. A soft rubber rib. Rib the inside of it so it's nice and smooth and clean looking. Water out of there. Okay, so that's pretty much what you end up with. Take the sponge, clean up the rim. Give you a nice clean rim. Okay, and you can take any kind of tool you want. Something similar to this. And I like to put this little spiral design in the bottom of my bowls. So I'm going to take this and go right there. And just slowly work my way out. That's it. That's my spiral. The bottom of the bowl. Okay, and this bowl can have some scallops on it. So we can do something similar to this. A little scallop design on it. keeping your finger wet, of course. Doesn't stick. That's it. It's the way you make a bowl. And there's lots of decorating things you can do. Okay, you can put some marks on it other than just those marks. You can do something like this. We'll use this pointed end. It's soft. Be very careful. Okay. And that's what Pine Creek Pottery does. They make bowls like this. They make mugs. They make jugs. They make plates. They make anything you would like to have. It's all made from raw clay, glazed and fired. Fired to stoneware. It can be ordered online. Pine Creek Pottery. .com. Go to my Etsy site and purchase this stuff. Purchase it at Ton Pottery in Central Lawrenceville, 43rd Street Gallery in Lawrenceville, Mystic Moon Antique and Artisans, Butler on Main Street, or in South Carolina at the Art Place Studio. And that's it. Thanks. Thank you for watching.